ito. So, out of this, what can you say or how will you define characters? Diba? You have described the characters a while ago by just seeing the pictures, but now how can you describe a character?
Ma'am.
How can you describe a character? Yes. You can unmute.
Ma'am, for me po, a character is someone who acts in a story. It can be a antagonist, protagonist, a supporting character. It can be a French character, and so on, ma'am.
And so on. So, those are the sample of characters. Yan, tama. Others who wants to add up. Is it possible that there's a story without a character? The same question I had given last time, is it possible na mayroong setting pero walang kwento? Or walang kwento, or may kwento na walang setting? Dito naman, posible ba na walang tauhan sa kwento?
No po.
Baka may alam kayong kwento na walang tauhan. Have you ever encountered? Because character is one of the salient features of a story. And so here is the definition of character or characters. They are the people, pwedeng people, pwedeng animal, pwedeng things that take action in the story. Hindi lang siya limited sa tao, hindi lang siya limited sa hayop, even objects. So can you give me samples of stories having animal characters? Nandito ba si, sino ba mga, si Maybelline? Can you have samples of stories with animal characters? Meron?
Ma'am,
Lion King, ma'am.
O sige, give examples.
The Call of the Wild.
Okay. Yes. So there are lots actually yung mga sample ng mga fables natin. How about things as characters in the story? Do you have samples?
Beauty and the Beast.
Yes. Very good. What else? Meron pa? Parang binigyan lang human characteristic. Naging... yung mga inanimate object ay binigyan ng characteristic na pang tao.
Cinderella po.
Cinderella, yes. Toys. Even Toy Story, they are not actually humans. They are toys, but they are given life. Usually sa mga fairy tales, yeah, Pinocchio as well. Yun yung mga usually na mga fairy tales and fantasies. Ay inanimate or even things. Ayan. How characters are defined? These are important terms for you to remember. When you say character, representation of a person, place, or thing performing traditionally human activities or functions in a work fiction, they are the one doing the action. And it's not possible for a story not to have characters. Kasi walang mag-develop na story kung walang kauhan. Next, let's have the definition of protagonist. The character where the story evolves. They are the one doing good deeds or the central character in the story. Kumbaga, sila ang bida. And we have the antagonist, the character or force that opposes. When you say opposes, the man versus man versus, halimbawa ay man versus beast, yung beast doon ang antagonist. Man versus supernatural, o kung sino man versus man, lagi siyang opposing sa protagonist. Then we also have minor character. When you say minor character, he provide or he should provide support and illuminates the protagonist. They are the one who parang pasok ang minor character ng sidekick at saka mga love interest, mga mentors, dito. They are the one who support and illuminates the protagonist. Then we have the what we call a static character, character that remains the same. So, nagsimula ang kwento, halimbawa siya ay walang pakialam. Tapos ang kwento, walang pakialam. Pag sinabi naman natin na yung wala bang pagbabago sa ugali, kung ano yung characterization niya from the beginning, yun na rin ang magiging characterization niya to the end. It is what we call static character. For example, halimbawa ang ating antagonist, he started as evil in the story. Then at the end of the story, he will be defeated as evil as well, still. Pag sinabi naman natin dynamic characters, yun yung may nare-realize na values at nagbabago. There's a change in the behavior or characteristics of the actor. That is what we call as dynamic. What do you mean by dynamic? For example, si Miss Min Shin. From the start, he is so strict and wants to make the main character suffer. The protagonist suffer. So, si Sarah, ang unting prinsesa. At the end of the story, she realized that she needs to change for the good. That's why from being evil, he started to she started to do good. Kaya siya ay tinaguri ang dynamic character. Nagbago siya. So, can you give me samples of characters that would fall under static, yung walang pagbabago throughout the story? And dynamic character, may pagbabago. Can you give one?
Very good mother po ni Cinderella.
Ano siya? Static or dynamic?
Static po.
Okay, very good. What else? Sino pa ang makapagbibigay ng sample ng static and dynamic characters? You can raise your hands, of course, or just volunteer. Meron pa?
Si, si Shrek, dynamic
si Shrek character. Ay, si Shrek, example ng dynamic character, di ba? Nung una ay parang he hates people, he hates to mingle, then afterwards, he developed a caring attitude. Yan, yan yung mga dynamic, nagbabago throughout the story. Then another term is the characterization. The choices an author makes to reveal a character's personality. So, tinatawag na characterization kapag ipinakita na ng author ang example natin, appearance, action, and dialogue as well as motivation of the author or of the character. So, ano po yung mga indicators ng characterization? Appearance, ano itsura ng character? Action, paano kumilos ang mga character na ito. Dialogue, paano sila magsalita, the choice of words. And motivations, what are their goals and purposes in the story. Yan po sila. So now, ayan po ang concrete definition ng characterization. the information the author gives the reader about the characters themselves. The author may give or may reveal the character in several ways. First, physical appearance. Second, what she says, thinks, feels, and dreams. Katulad nyo nung diniscuss ko kanina, parang sa... Nasaan na yung slide? Ako naghang. Next, what does he do or not do? Katulad nito yung kanina. Appearance, actions, dialogues, and motivations. Sa appearance, ito yung first. Ano itsura niya? Yung second, paano siya nagsasalita? Anong nararamdaman niya and others? Pangatlo, ano yung ginagawa niya at hindi niya ginagawa? At pang-apat, what do you think others would say or describe about him? Diba? Another form of characterization kung paano ka ilarawan ng iba and how others would react to you. That's also a form of characterization. Ayan. Let's now have the two kinds of characterization. Somebody read and differentiate. Nandito ba si Alcantara?
Yes, boss. In their characterization, it comes right out and states what a trait a character has. They are bossy or quiet or polite. While in their characterization, which is much more common, is when the author gives us insight into what a character is like based on what they say, do, wear, think, feel, own, or even through how other characters react to them. So, I can give the example in their characterization, like in the story of Cinderella. So, Cinderella is a direct characterization because not only sa pagsasalita niya po makikita yung character niya, but most of all is the physical appearance and the actions of Cinderella on her own. While in indirect characterization is yung pwede po dito maging example is yung pong sister niya. Yung mga sister niya po kasi hindi naman po talaga kumbaga po hindi dahil sa tulong ng author dahil sa ginagawa nila kay Cinderella hindi natin makikilala yung mga character. Thank you po.
Okay. Very good. Precisely. Kapag direct na sinabi ng author ang katangian o yung mismong character halimbawa yun na nga classy or bossy, quiet, or polite, direct na description siya. Yun po yung tinatawag natin na direct. Pero halimbawa, ang sinasabi lang ng author, paano magsalita, para i-describe o ipinapa-imagine sa atin, paano sila magsalita, anong ginagawa nila, anong itsura, anong sinusuot nila. Hindi sinabing ang protagonist or ang anak ni ganito, or ang stepsisters ni Cinderella ay mga pangit. Hindi naman direct na sinabi. Sinabi, they are having, halimbawa, dinidescribe ko na itsura. Halimbawa, they are wearing loose clothes. Their hair are ganun, ganun. Diba dinidescribe lang? Hindi naman direct sinabi na hindi naman direct sinabi na pangit, kundi dinescribe kung paano siya mag-arrive on that characteristic na pangit, di ba? Oh, halimbawa, how others would react. Hindi sinabi na direct na masamang ugali, kundi ang sinabi ay, halimbawa ay, hindi siya gusto ng ibang mga tauhan. Yun, pwedeng ganun. Direct and indirect characterization ang tawag doon. So, characters are convincing if they are consistent, motivated, and lifelike. They resemble real people. So, ito ay in reiteration na din sa ating discussion a while ago. characters may be individual or developing or static. So individual characters may be round, many-sided and complex personalities. When we say many-sided and complex, iba-iba o parang naparang yung personalidad. When you say developing, there's a change in the personality. Pwedeng nagbago ang tauhan for better or worse by the end of the story. And when we talk about static, have one or two characteristics that never change and emphasize. Halimbawa, si Detective Conan, dinescribe siya as a brilliant detective. Sabang ng huli, brilliant detective pa rin siya. Yung cruel stepmother ni Cinderella, hindi nagbago. Simula ng kwento, siya ay nagmamalupit. At the end of the story, nagmamalupit pa rin siya. So therefore, he is a static character. Let's now have the extension definition of protagonist. Somebody read, and what is the other term for protagonist? Sinong babasa? Somebody?
Ni po, ma'am.
Sige.
Po, protagonist. The protagonist, or pronounced protagonist, is the main character in a story. Also called the central character, focal character, primary character, or hero. The protagonist plays a key role in a narrative's development because the story revolves around them. They encounter some internal or external conflict that drives the plot, and they tend to experience transformative change that incites the climax and resolves the narrative.
Okay, so if you would notice, sila daw yung may mga internal or external conflict. So pwedeng internal because the protagonist would struggle between himself or herself, pwedeng yung kanyang kalaban or katunggali as conflict ay ang kanyang sarili. Pwede namang iba, man versus others, man versus beast, man versus supernatural, man versus nature, di ba? And man versus society. So ilan lang yan sa mga sample. Kaya siya ay internal kapag kalaban niya ay sarili niya, at external kapag iba naman. So, other term for protagonist is central character, focal character, or primary character. So, in other words, he is called as the hero in the story. So, naman tayo sa next. Ayan. May mga types of protagonist pala tayo. First, what is a lonely hero? Somebody read. Daniela ba ito? Sige, nag-volunteer na. Sige.
And ako na lang po, ma'am. Lonely hero. The lonely hero is the standard strain of protagonist, probably because it's seen as the most heroic type. As the name implies, the lonely hero is the one and only person who can stop evil from triumphing and save the day. That they are usually helped by a team of supporting characters. The ultimate burden of the quest falls squarely on the shoulders of the lonely hero. There are one who must sacrifice the most in order to accomplish their goal. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so meron pala tayong tinatawag na lonely hero. Okay, so since siya's okay, lonely hero is the one and only person who can stop evil. So wala palang ibang makakatulong sa kanya kundi ang kanyang sarili, or wish we could say walang ibang makakatulong sa kanya or walang ibang makakagapi sa kalaban kundi siya lamang. So he is always portrayed as why he is called lonely hero? pwede siyang tulungan pala ng iba, ng ibang supporting characters, pero yung burden or yung pinakang paghihirap or sakripisyo ay laging siya ang nagdadala. So, he is the one who do most the sacrifice in order to accomplish the goal. He is called as the lonely hero. Yan po yung tinatawag natin na lonely hero. Para bagang sinasabi na kapasa niya ang lahat, ang mundo, dahil siya ang talagang inaasahan to triumph versus evil. Let's now proceed with the next type of protagonist. Ito yung mga sample ng lonely hero. Harry from Harry Potter, Katniss Everdeen from The Hunger Games, Frodo Baggins from Lord of the Rings, Matilda from Matilda, and Cooper from Interstellar. So, i-take note niyo yung mga examples na iyan. As you might be asked about given a test to give examples. Hindi naman tayo sa next. Ayaw mag-next. Wait lang. Yan, meron naman tayong next group hero. What do you mean by group hero? Volunteer. You can read and tell something about group hero. Raise your hands. Or no need to raise pala at hindi ko naman kita. O ano daw? Nandito ba si Stephanie? Si Stephanie Guinevere, nandito ba? Others?
Mama, hindi lang.
Hindi lang po, ma'am.
You can read. What do you mean the group of hero? Anyone can volunteer, mag-unmute na lang.
Wala lang, ma'am.
Okay.
Group hero. With group hero protagonists, multiple people are equally involved in the story's main events and conflict. They may not all serve the same purpose or perform the same task, but pull together to accomplish a single goal. No one person stands out beyond the rest. Or if they do, it's only because the group helped them get there. Whereas the lonely hero can, and ultimately does, rise to the occasion alone. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so one best example of the group hero is the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Ano pa yung mga grupuhan? Yung mga superheroes na halimbawa ay Power Rangers, Powerpuff Girls. Ano pa mga mabibigyan yung example ng group hero?
Avengers.
Yan, Voltes 5. Meron pa?
Avengers po.
Avengers. So, those are the characters which go in group or in pairs. Kaya, they are what they call as the group hero. Yan yung mga example natin. Avengers, ano pa? Si Fred, Daphne, Velma, Shaggy, and Scooby from Scooby-Doo, Violet, Claws, and Sunny from A Series of Unfortunate Events, Romeo and Juliet from Romeo and Juliet, Ivy Lynn Clark, Minnie Jackson, and Eugenia, Skeeter, Phelan from The Help. So, ayan yung mga samples, and usually, yung mga group ng heroes, yung mga Avengers, ano pa, Fantastic Four, ano pa, The Incredibles, they are examples of group heroes. Ikatlo naman, we have the anti-hero. Pakibasa? What is an anti-hero?
Mama ko na lang po.
Okay.
Type of protagonist. Although protagonists are usually shown as selfless, kind, and courageous, they can also be captured, sacrific, and perhaps less than morally upright. In other words, they might be an anti-hero, a hero without typically heroic traits.
Okay, so they are the characters na hindi mo akalain na magiging hero. So, they might tend to be selfless, kind, and courageous heroes. Yun yung usual na karakteristik ng mga protagonist. Pero there would be instances na yung hero pala ay minsan sarcastic, bitter, less morally upright. Yung parang wala siyang katangian ng pagiging hero, pero at the end of the story, siya yung nagiging hero. Wala siyang heroic traits, in other words. Ayan. So, an anti-hero starts off as either an impartial party or a lesser villain who begrudgingly engages in conflict with the main antagonist. Usually because there's something in it for them. Ayan. So, para baga what we call as bidang kontra bida, in other words. Ayan. Example natin from literature. Artemis from Artemis Fowl, Holden Caulfield from Catcher in the Rye, Black Lamora from the Gentleman Bastard series, and Thomas Covenant from the Chronicles of Thomas Covenant. So I will be further showing you other examples of anti-heroes pag dinistas ko na yung heroic archetypes. Yan yung question. Dun sa types of protagonists, nag 3 p.m. na ba? Oo. Okay. So, anong characteristics niya? Can be a protagonist a bad guy? Ang bida ba'y pwedeng bad guy? Anong sagot ninyo?
Yes po.
Yes, ano explanation? Po. Somebody who wants to explain, bakit kaya siya tinatawag or bakit pwedeng maging main hero or main character ang isang bad guy? Bakit ma'am, protagonist pa rin siya? Who wants to explain?
Ma'am, try ko lang po.
Okay.
A protagonist can be a bad guy for the reason that he or she may take a revenge on someone who did a bad thing to them. For example, din po is yung Robin Hood. Those are kind of examples na kahit po bida po sila, they can be a bad guy since meron po silang mga pinaglalaban or may kailangan po silang patunayan para may paglaban yung kabutihan. Ganun po, ma'am. Thank
yes,
you po.
Okay. So, they could be bad sometimes or even described as bad. One best example for that niya is si Grinch, di ba? Lagi siyang nang bubuli or ano bang tawag doon? Lagi siyang nagpa-prank ng mga tao. Pero at the end, he is the one who saved Christmas. Another example, si Maleficent, di ba? Parang bidang kontrabida nga siya. He is known to be bad, but then at the end, he was able to save the princess, di ba? Or to provide assistance to the princess. Yeah. Let's now talk about antagonists. He is the primary opponent of the protagonist and the biggest obstacle standing between the main character and the goal. Ang ibig sabihin ng antagonist ay from the Greek anti, meaning against, and agonist, meaning actor. Kaya siya ay tinawag na antagonist, anti-actor. So types of antagonist naman kayo. Kanina kasi napakita na natin yung sample ng hero. So somebody to read and tell something about the villain?
Ma'am.
Okay.
Villain. When you think antagonist, the first thing that comes to mind is probably a classic evil-doing character. This is, of course, the villain antagonist seen so often in stories from Dickens to Disney. Not only do the villain's goals oppose the protagonist, they are also actively working against them in order to fulfill their own, often selfish or wicked ambitions.
Okay. So when you say villain from the word itself, okay, the villain is opposing the protagonist. So they are working against them in order to fulfill their own. So ibig sabihin talaga, they are the one doing evil things. That is what we call as villain. Kumbaga sa hero, ang kalaban ng hero ay villain. Let's have the next. The villain may have long-standing grudge. So, ang main purpose bakit sila nagiging villain ay para maghiganti sa protagonist. So, ayan, si Syndrome, ang sample natin ng villain sa novel or movie or story na The Incredibles. Another, si Joker. Akalaban siya, villain siya ni Batman in The Dark Knight. Yun bang magiging villain ka kapag ang motive mo ay maghiganti at gumawa ng kasamaan? That's the characterization of an antagonist, specifically a villain. Ayan, sample natin ng mga villain. Si Voldemort from Harry Potter, si Darth Vader from Star Wars, si Hans Gruber from Die Hard, Sauron from Lord of the Rings, and Cruella de Vil from 101 Dalmatians. Meron din tayong tinatawag na group villain. Kanina meron tayong group hero. So, just as with protagonist, an antagonist doesn't have to be one person working alone. Pwedeng group din siya ng mga kalaban. It could be an entire group that opposes the bida. So, they are considered, ito example, the community from The Giver, the capital from The Hunger Games, the Republic of Gilead from Handmaid's Tale. Those are examples of group villain. Let's now have the next page. Meron tayong tinatawag na inanimate forces as another example. Though not as common as human antagonist, when you say inanimate forces, yan yung mga hindi mo maiiwasan beyond your control. Example natin dyan, nature, technology, supernatural. They can create resistance that a protagonist needs to overcome. Sila yung mga humahadlang sa bida para ma-fulfill nila ang kanilang goal. Hindi sila tao, they are nature, technology, or supernatural. The inanimate force antagonist may take a form akin to a human figure. Pwede silang magsatao or magsarobot, katulad nga po ng Terminator. Mga best example natin. So now let's continue. Such inanimate forces may be on par with unfathomably terrifying threats of cosmic horror, or they may be as mundane as bad weather. Pwede nga pong weather. Okay, so those are example. But either way, this force blocks protagonist's path to victory and must be neutralized before they can succeed. Example natin ng inanimate force as antagonist, nature in Robinson Crusoe. So yung nature na pahirap kay Robinson Crusoe while he is trapped on the island, diba? Let's have the next, ano pa? Technology in Terminator franchise and the supernatural in the story, The Mask of the Red Death. Okay, examples. So meron din tayong tinatawag na intrinsic forces. So ano ba ang intrinsic forces? Somebody to read?
Intrinsic forces. This is another type of antagonist that isn't the character, but rather one of the protagonist's own shortcomings that keep them from achieving their goals. An intrinsic force drives the character versus self, conflict you'll sometimes see in the stories. This may be a personality flaw or some sort of physical disadvantage, but it's something that the protagonist and those around them must defeat or give into, especially if they have a hero to villain arc.
Okay, so that is what we call as intrinsic, di ba? Yung ang pwede mo maging problema yung sarili mo, your shortcomings, your problems na sarili mo, halimbawa ay yung character, walang tiwala sa sarili, walang kumpiyansa. That's why he felt he cannot do things right. So yung mga halimbawa, insecurities, personality flaw, na hindi pagtitiwala sa sarili. That's an example of intrinsic forces. Ano pa? Halimbawa ay kapalaluan ng bida. Halimbawa ay pagiging mayabang. Paniniwala na siya ang pinakang magaling. Those could fall under intrinsic forces. Yung mga ugali ng bida na hindi maganda. Let's continue. The other thing to remember about the intrinsic force antagonist is that it may not be the only antagonist in the story. Pwede kasi magsama-sama ang mga factor na yan. Pwedeng may external at may internal forces na humahad lang sa bida. Let's still continue. Sample natin dito. And other things to remember about intrinsic force antagonists is that it may not be the only antagonist in a story. Frodo batting both his own desire for the ring and his ultimate enemy, Sauron. So, other siya. Na application siya, halimbawa si Frodo, yung character na si Frodo Baggins, he is battling with himself or his own desire. Aside from the other enemy, ito yung katulad ng sinasabi ko na pwedeng marami siyang forces na humahad lang sa kanya, pwedeng sarili niya, plus other people. Sample natin, si Elizabeth sa Pride and Prejudice. Dito naman sa isa, sa intrinsic force, si Edgar Allan Poe, yung narrator's paranoia or pagiging paranoid. Sa Edgar Allan Poe's The Telltale Heart. Next. Other example, Henry the Tumble's uncontrollable time traveling in The Time Traveler's Wife. And yung mga example in how we have described the protagonist and antagonist and what's the rivalry between the protagonist and antagonist. Somebody to read this one. Oh, Pakisuyo, who wants to help me read this one?
Ma'am, ako na lang ito.
Asya, sige.
Pride and Prejudice. Protagonist Elizabeth Bennet, antagonist her prejudice, particularly against Darcy. Rivalry. Though Jane Austen introduced several smaller obstacles between Elizabeth and Darcy, Lady Catherine de Vouch, Caroline Bingley, Mr. Collins, and George Wycombe. The truth is that the main obstacle between Elizabeth and Darcy is their pride and prejudice, which they must overcome in order to be together. Thank you po, ma'am.
Okay, so that's the main, according to her, na ano natin na si Elizabeth ang bida, ang antagonist ay her prejudice. Diba? Sarili siya, sarili din niya ang kanyang naging kalaban. So her prejudice particularly against Darcy. Well, let's have the next. Ah, yun yung sample na pa-end na. Okay na natin. Sunod pa. So that would be the last slide. I will be giving more examples pa sa susunod. I will be uploading this in our Google Classroom and give more examples pa. Since it's 3:36, we extended the allotted 2 hours. Ginawa natin 3 hours kasi combined classes naman kayo. That's why medyo nag-overtime tayo. So everyone, can you turn on your camera for today as part of the attendance? Okay. Pakiano na lang, open your cam so we could have this shot of attendance. For others, let's wait for others. I'll stop sharing now. Okay. O yung iba. I-together mode natin. Others, ayan. Together mode na tayo.